Hello, welcome. Well, you're here to manage some illness in the body. That's okay, we can take care of that. If you're not actually experiencing some illness, you can skip to a different video, that's fine. But welcome here, right now. This is a good time to be here now. All right, should we get started? You probably are real familiar with the experience in your body that you're having. But let's settle for just a moment and awaken our meditative arts so that we can look at this illness, this dysfunction in the body, in a different way. All right then, let's see. Begin by just resting, and the world out there is at some distance, and that gives us an opportunity to just be here and to just rest for a few minutes. The breathing can become natural and full. A few deep breaths are okay, but then settling to a natural breathing through the nose is good. The excess tension that's easy to let go from the body can just let go and fall away. All right, we know that there are cells in the body and chemistry and neurology that aren't working in a beautiful way. The synergy isn't quite there. And it's probably easy to feel this as discomfort or pain. You can say you're in pain, but rather let's say the pain is in you. You are bigger than that, and there are many parts that are working well. The illness is just in a place. And you've probably done enough research to know what organ or system in the body this illness is with. We have our physical body, and just above that we have an imaginal body, a way of meeting the illness in an imaginal sense. Like when somebody says, "Oh, tell me about your illness," you would say, "It is like this. It looks like this. It feels like this." So we attribute a little more imaginal or imaginary experiences to an illness. Let's take that in a very deliberate way. Take it a step further. Looking at that place in the body, you can see it is in a space, in a place in the body, and it has the familiar sensations. So let's lift that area of illness out of the body and hold it between us right now, disassociated from the body, so we can examine it. Usually we can see the size and shape and color, texture, maybe sounds, very elemental experiences, heat or cold. But let's look in a little more detail here. We can see the dysfunction happening. It's probably very easy if you just clear your mind completely and not attempt to grasp at the imagery. You might see the imagery just forming that is a little more functional. Think of if something is being held too tightly, it's being clamped or tied up or compressed. If it's held too loosely, it's expanding, it's falling apart. If it's too hot, maybe there's fire there. If it's too cold, maybe it's snow or ice. We can think of levers and pulleys. We can think of simple machinery that may hammer or compress or pull things apart. Think of the elements, the mechanics that are going on here. You can also shift a little out of mechanics and think of it artistically. What is ugly looking? What is in the wrong place? What needs to come alive or be suppressed? All of this more functional imagery can start to form and start to be seen in how it's all working or not working together. Everything has to be just right in a watch. Every little gear and spring has to be just right and in balance for it to work well. So those images probably easily come to mind. Now let's go a step further. As we're holding this out in front of us, if we can see what's not going well, we can start to bring in the elements or the function that would create wellness. And it's okay, we can do that with this. Notice there's a little persistence of the illness image because supposedly you have been doing, excuse me, but the meditation of illness for quite some time. We're going to meditate on this particular mechanical function or artistic function of wellness now. To see the blood flow moving properly, the hormones moving properly, the cells functioning well in this particular area, everything in balance and everything working well. What does that look like now? What communication goes on here? What forces are at play? What beauty is in place? See everything working together, you know, like a nicely designed machine or nice element of nature. There could be mechanical devices, there could be a garden, there could be elements from nature like air and water or warmth. See this working and functioning beautifully now, all the parts and pieces working together. If it's hard to come up with the images, if you feel that there's more that you could come up with, then after this session, you can go do some research online to see the anatomy and the physiology. Take that anatomy and physiology and turn it into this rich symbolic language. What we're doing here is there is a truer self and there's a mind. But in between all that and the body, there is symbolic imagery. It's, you know, can I speak poetically and say it's the language of the soul sitting right between the physical and the sort of etherical? There is an imagery that is an intermediary between the mental functions, we'll say, and the physical body. And that is the rich symbolic imagery that I'm encouraging to wake up and come forward. The imagery that comes out of that sort of silent space and comes with a life of its own. Okay, you're beginning to see the well working here. You're beginning to see all the function in order. Now it's time to reassociate. Let me help bring this imagery back into the body here. And I release it into the body and see how that balance and that health starts knitting together with the other areas of the body that have balance and health. The communication is working. The hormones are flowing. The cells of this new functioning area are integrating with the cells around, all to have this knit together health experience. All right, the body moves slowly. The physical world sort of moves slowly. A rock doesn't get up and run away. The chemistries in the body have to come and go in their own time. So repeating this imagery as you're repetition as your object of focus of meditation, over time, the cells of the body change, the chemistry, the systems of the body change to integrate this new imagined health. Because all health begins in the imaginal. All right. Practice this on your own. You have to become a master at this healing quality, a master at this ability to heal yourself. All right. Remember your meditations morning and evening every day. It'll be so much help. Okay. Be well.